Good morning, traders. This is Frank Cholly with RJO Futures in Chicago, coming to you on Wednesday morning, August 22nd, with your grain market morning commentary. Currently, we have grains trading a little lower across the board. Right now, corn's about 3 to 4 lower, soybeans 10 to 12 lower, and the wheat 7 to 8 lower. In the outside markets, we have the dollar's up a little, the treasury's up a little, and the equities are down. So the safe haven trades, the dollar and the treasury, a little better today, a bit of a reversal from what we saw yesterday. In fact, you should make a point, take a look at the Dow Jones futures and the S&P futures. Look at those charts, a rejection of yesterday's high prices, maybe a key reversal. That could change things in the grain markets too, if in fact we have a key reversal. But again, the story with the grains this week is all eyes are on the crop tours that are underway right now. So we got a lot of bad news as far as, you know, the corn and soybeans go, and we probably are likely to get a little bit of better news. Maybe not what we would like to see in terms of improving yields, but better than what we got the last day or so. So the market has gone through a big rally off of that disappointing yield news. We got 35 to 40 cent rally just this week in corn. And we're closer to 85 or 90 cent rally in the soybeans. So we've priced in a lot more damage. The market is likely, in my opinion, to, you know, pause for a little bit, digest some of this news and see if we continue to get disappointing news or if we start to get a little bit of better news and maybe the market does a little bit of back and fill. You know what, I always say that corrections are healthy for the markets, and I'm gonna beat that drum until it finally happens. At some point, producers plant more acres, high prices, we see demand destruction. At some point, grain prices will eventually come down. So, you know, what's the cure for high prices? High prices. So, we also have September grain option expiration this Friday, so keep an eye on that. A lot of times, as I said before, the market seems to gravitate to a price level where we have the most open interest between puts and calls combined. So look at that open interest, see what strike they target this Friday, and wait and see how these crop tours wrap up towards the end of the week. So that's all I have time for now. Please feel free, give me a call, 800-826-4124. And as always, remember that trading commodity futures does involve substantial risk of loss and is not suitable for everyone. Thank you.